Are you interested in vintage technology? Or have you ever dreamed of building your own computer? Or have you built one and now want to connect it to a TV or monitor? Then a video card based on the TMS9918 video display processor, or VDP for short, might be the solution for you. In this video, I'll show you how to build a VDP-based video card and how it works. Stay tuned. Well, the VDP is a single chip solution for connecting TVs or monitors with composite input. TVs can of course also be controlled via the antenna input using a modulator. TMS9928 for NTSC and TMS9929 for PAL have separate outputs for luminance and color difference signals. These need additional encoders. The VDPs have a resolution of 256 by 192 pixels with 15 colors plus transparency, a text mode with 40 columns and 24 lines, and up to 32 sprites. In my previous video, I showed more details about the VDP itself and its capabilities. The VDP can be connected directly to an 8-bit data bus. It uses its own dynamic RAM to which it has exclusive access. In the manual, you can find an application example for 16 kilobyte of video RAM made with 8 MOS4116 dynamic RAM chips. The 4116 chips have a capacity of 16 kilobit, not kilobyte. You can see the D-in pin whose input bit is written to memory and the D-out pin that outputs the stored bit. So, 8 of these need to be put together in order to get 16 kilobyte. But the 4116 has several downsides. First, it needs 3 different supply voltages. And as we need 8 of these ICs, the circuit quickly becomes messy and didn't work for me either. Furthermore, the 4116 are no longer made, so with an average price of $3 per piece, they are rather expensive on eBay. Luckily, I found a workaround on Hackaday. This works with 374574. These contain 8 D ledges each and sit between the 8 combined data and address lines of the VDP and a 32 kilobyte static RAM chip. But before we can understand how this works, we need to understand how the 4116 chips function. Okay, first let's have a look on the pinout. Now you may ask yourself why the 4116 has only 7 address lines, don't you? We know that 14 address pins are needed to address 16 kilobits. So how is this issue solved? Well, the address is split up into 2 portions, the row address and the column address. These are applied one after the other to the 7 address pins. After the 4116 has received the complete address, it either outputs the bit on its data out pin or stores the bit it gets in on its data in pin. Other than dynamic RAM, the static RAM awaits the addresses on all its address pins simultaneously. Here, 2 of the 574 latch the row and column addresses, so that the RAM chip sees the complete address when the read or write signal comes up. The VDP shares the same pins for addresses and for data, so we need a third 574 to latch the data bits. I also added a simple 1 transistor driver stage to the composite output. This is because the output is designed for a 470 ohm pull-down resistor, but the composite input of monitors and TVs generally have a resistance of 75 ohms. It also works without this, but I just wanted to make sure that my valuable VDP is well protected. I wired this circuit to an Arduino on a solderless breadboard and now it works perfectly, as I showed in my previous video. Now I'm planning to do more projects with this chip, but I don't want to rebuild the circuit every time. So I decided to build the whole thing on the circuit board. One possibility is to use prototype boards. But it is very tedious to solder everything and you easily make mistakes, which are then difficult to fix as you can imagine. So this time I decided to build it on a PCB. You can of course make PCBs by yourself, but for this you need special equipment and nasty chemicals. If you only make occasional one-line pieces, it is not worth it, but luckily I discovered PCBgogo. PCBgogo offers numerous services all around printed circuit boards. In addition to standard FR4 boards, custom-made boards are also available, for example, from Aluminium or Rogers. And all this within 24 hours. If you don't want to swing the soldering iron yourself, they can also assemble all sorts of PCBs for you. Highest quality is ensured by the most modern testing methods. I first had a small error in my Gerber files, but thanks to their competent worldwide support, the problem was quickly solved. And so PCBgogo has more than 100,000 satisfied customers all over the world. Become a customer now and enjoy a $30 discount on the cost of components of your first PCB assembly order. Order your PCB right now. The link is in the video description. And now the boards have arrived. They are of the good quality that I had talked about in the ad, exactly what I expected. Soldering was a pleasure and it did not even take half an hour to put everything together. And this is how it finally turned out. A DIY graphic card for homebrew computers. The pin header can be populated as you prefer, either Arduino-like with female pin headers or breadboard-friendly like so. The power pins have been placed so that they fit into the power rail of a solderless breadboard. The card can now be wired directly to an Arduino. On my GitHub page you can find all the schematics, gerber files and an Arduino library with examples for all the different display modes. Download the zip file and then install it via the Arduino IDE. In the examples folder you find a use case for every display mode, including sprites. Uncomment the one that you like to try, then compile and upload the sketch to the Arduino. Plug in the composite input of your TV or monitor and enjoy. And it can also be connected to any other platform like my homemade Z80 computer. We do need a bit of glue logic though, but we can now use it with a TV and enjoy the real home computer magic of the 80s. But I will talk about that more in detail in another video. Subscribe to this channel and enable notifications so you won't miss it and help the algorithm to recommend this video to as many people as possible. Thanks a lot. Oh, and I almost forgot. Supporters get access to ad-free preview videos and other goodies. Check out my Patreon page. That's all about it for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.